time.
And it's important to realize that you know, the first partial of the harmonic series, you see it's a C in the bass clef, a C3, I believe. Am I right? Okay, good. You can speak, don't worry. And it's, notice that you, no beginner trumpet player will ever play that. Probably not high school students. The range that you will see will typically be from the second partial all the way up to the eighth partial. So from this C all the way up to this C. So let's take a look at this for a second. You have, Derek, can I change something real quick?
Yeah.
This is probably my OCD. I just had to move it up a little bit. But you were right, you still see. So this is 1, 2, and it's at an A flat.
It's supposed to, right? No?
Think about.
That makes so much sense.
So, okay, so you want to change your answer?
I don't know.
I mean, I'll do it for you. I just.
I couldn't tell if it was like on the line or.
It's kind of, it was, make sure we just know it is definitely a B flat. And for homework, you were to do the rest of them, you know, all the way down, all the positions, well, first through seventh position. I'm going to look at that in a second. What I want us to do now is to add four more. Does anyone know what the intervals are between 8, 9, 9, 10, 10, 11, 11, and 12? What's between 8 and 9?
A whole step.
A whole step? 9 and 10? A whole step? 10 and 11? A whole step? And then 11 and 12? So let's do this. Paige, will you come up and write the ninth partial? Monica, will you come up and write the tenth? And Madison, come up and write the 11th.
Okay.
But just remember, it's just a major second up from that note, major second up from that up. Yes.
Did you do it?
So what note is that, Paige? You know, they must not teach you about C's and theories.
D?
Yes.
Yeah, they can count.
Perfect, you got it. It's all right, if we were flute players, we would know, right? Or piano, I'm sorry.
I just don't like playing that high. That's not a fun range.
Alright, so let's look at this. So looking at this, the 8 is what note?
C.
9 is
D.
D, which is a major second up, right?
Yeah.
9 to 10 is a major second up, right?
Yeah.
Which is D to
E.
E. And then, so.
Yeah.
F.
Sharp.
F sharp. Now. Mr. Bainbridge. knowing, I want you to know, no one say a thing. Number 12. What do you think the 12th partial would be, considering you know everything below it? Where do you think it's naturally just going to go to? Yeah. Yeah, it's going to go to G, right? Well, you said so. So that's a minor second. How else can I figure that out? Divide 12 by 2 is 6. What's 6? G. And divide 6 by 2? 3. That's another way of thinking about it. So, partials 1, 2, what's next? 4, 8, 16 are going to be all C's, right? 4 first position. And then, what am I missing? 3, 6, 12 would be what?
G.
G. All right, good. And then what notes am I missing here? 5 and 10.
E.
Thank you, Monica. And then 7 and 14, which we don't go to 14, but if we were, we could do B flat. Alright, and then what else are we missing? 11?
9.
Oh, 9? What is 9? 9 is D. 11 is?
F sharp.
Now, just realize that these, definitely 7, definitely 11. Are way out of tune. You're never going to use those. That's just the way that the harmonic series works. So looking at this, you know 12. So for your homework, I'm just going to do a quick check. Sweet. For your homework, I want you to go up to just add 4 more. To each one of those 7. Is that okay? Doable? Yes? Okay, good. That's your homework. And just remember, from 8 to 9, major second. 9 to 10, major second. 10 to 11, major second. 11 to 12, minor second. Now, you will also realize that when we go over all the harmonic series for trombone, for horn, for tuba, it's all the same. It follows the same intervals. Not necessarily the same fundamental note. All right. I wrote up there first position, second position, third, all the way down to 7. When you hear the word position, what instrument do you think about? Trombone, right? B shooters.
Yeah.
Don't say that to a trombone player. Or Professor Cook. Those follow also the fingering charts, or the fingering sequence. Can we just go down, Madison, can you do first position drawing the 3 circles? And coloring in which one valve you would press down. Monica, we should do second position. Page, third.
Yes, I am left-handed.
We could do different colors. might we just put them on the, yeah, thank you.
Hopefully you know your fingers.
I don't know why it bothers me, the face closed. And then, of course, I know I can't draw it, right? Is that right?
Except that your lines for where the C should be in line with each other.
What?
With your C lines? The first line, nope, on the top.
Oh. Yes, I was like, wait, I know that's a C. Okay.
It just bothered me.
Announcing?
Well, you know what? Yes. Two, three, four. Well, the lines are not really. All right. Does anyone object?
The motion passes.
Aye.
No. All in favor?
Aye.
Any abstain? Abstentions? Abstentions? Any opposed? Okay, good. Now, show me on here, where is the first valve slide? Who would like to come up and point to the first valve slide? On my beautiful cornet. Okay, put your case in front of you. Open it up. Don't take out your trumpet. And what term did I just say? First
valve
slide. All right, so when I say first valve, point to the first valve. Good, check your neighbor, make sure it's all good. All right, then, if I say first valve slide, then look what's close, what would be attached to it? Yes, okay, that is your first valve slide. Now, show me your second valve slide. Good, good, you good? Yes. So, a lot of times you're going to have students who, like, just, you know, they're going to pull, they're going to touch, they're going to do everything. It is important, because I forgot to tell you, that when you pull out a slide, your second valve, first valve, third valve, you need to make sure the valve is pressed. That helps alleviate the pressure. And here you didn't hear the popping noise. Over time, now they say like over time, if you keep on doing that, the popping noise, it messes up the pressure of the instruments, messes up the valves, the inner mechanics of the horn. So, and also it just, I don't know. Just always tell them to press down the valve when they remove the slide. Now, when they remove the main slide, you know, that's fine. Now, point to the third valve slide. Yeah, where is your third valve slider? Like, what is there a hand already on it when you're playing it?
Yeah.
And what is that? Okay, now figure this out for me. You have first valve, second valve, and third valve. Our brains for this. If I wanted to think about if I pushed which one, and I just want to go to half a step, which valve do you think I would push? Think about it, don't say it out loud. If I just want to go down half a step, just by looking at the tubing, which one would you press? Would you press the first valve? Would you press the second valve? Or would you press the third valve? Which means it would go through the third valve slide. Or if you press the second valve, it goes through the second valve slide. Same for first. Think about that. Who says the third valve slide? Who says the first valve slide? Okay, who says the second? All right. Why?
Because the second valve slide is the smallest, so it's going to lower it.
Yes, if the second valve slide is the smallest, it's going to raise it down just a half a pitch. Now, so it's important you do know that. What about this? A whole step. We know that the second valve is not. Did I say something wrong?
No.
Oh. You know, I'm making a lot of mistakes. So, what about to go a whole step? Looking at it, making some. Who says third valve slide? Who says first? All right, good. And then to go a whole step and a half down, you do what? Does that make sense? All right, so that also means it follows this pattern as well. Oh. So think about it. This goes down half a step. This goes down a whole step. This goes down what? One and a half. This goes down two. Now why? Let's look at this. Okay, we got that right because if I just press second valve, it goes down half a step. That goes down a whole step, right? If I just press first valve. Okay, so now let's do some adding. I press the first valve. And then I press the second valve. That means it's got to go a whole step and a half step. So one and a half. Two and three. If you press down just second, it goes down how many half steps? Just a half. If I press down the third valve slide, it goes down
one
and a half, which equals?
Two.
Does this make sense?
Two and a half.
So, Mr. Bainbridge. Oh, sorry, wait. Connor, since you haven't come up today, if I press down third and first, Does that help you understand it? Okay, all right. There are so many different ways you can look at this, and I was trying to think of a simple way. So it is important that you know that. And the more I read about brass, the more I know. So it makes sense, right? The more you read, the more you know. Okay, unless you watch fake news. Okay, good, good. So what long tone would you like to start off on first? What note?
G.
Okay. And then I have the cameras locked up, so.
Mm-hmm.
lip slurs. What is a lip slur? What's a slur? What's a lip slur?
Go from one note to the other.
Yeah, you go from one note to the other without taking on. See if you can do that again. Got to do something different here, right? What do you have to do? I'm going to start on E. Derek, will you show me the fingering for E? Good. Now everyone show me the fingering for E. Good. Check your neighbor. Everyone good. All right. Here we go. I'm going to play for four. You play for four. Ready? Madison, you want to give us one?
Sure.
Or give us two examples?
Okay.
fight. Probably never been serviced. It's been in my attic. So, good. You're hearing the rhythm while you're playing, right? So the next thing is, once they start getting really comfortable with that, I love throwing them off and going. See if you can clear that out. One, I'm starting on E. Two, ready, go. Now, if here's another thing, I do that in elementary methods when we're talking about maybe recorder, maybe we're doing some type of solfege, kind of playing around. So again, it's a call and response. They're using their listening skills, which is really important. So you can do exercises like that to warm up with. Anything else that maybe you could do to review, first off, their listening skills. They need to be doing that, not just playing. Anything else maybe you've experienced or...
You can do that, but also like
relate
it to like a song that they already know.
Mm-hmm. Totally. Let's go. So since we're warmed up, let's go to the book. What number did we leave off? Or what number did we stop at yesterday? We stopped at 8. So here is some advice for you as a teacher. I always, always, even though I would never, let's just say we ended on number 8. The next day, I may go back to 7 and then go to 8 again and then learn. It's kind of like go back and review and add more. I also don't just go out of the book. I make sure I have supplemental materials, which are things you can make. Maybe they're and it has to have a focus, right? It has to go over maybe rhythms. Maybe it's going over note names. Maybe it's doing both. Maybe it's reinforcing what they're learning in the book. You know, so you can't just always go out of the book. I find that very boring, and I think you're missing a lot of things if you're just doing that. You're also going to be playing, you know, by this time, maybe you're getting ready for the Christmas holiday, whatever, winter concert. So that's something else. But anyway, all right, let's remember number 8. What are we doing for D? What's important? Yeah, you better kick out. We always said kick out. Kick out your third vowel slot. All right. We'll work on it, Jake. All right, here we go. Number 8. 1. Sorry. Let's hear the note first. All right, so let's try it this time. Remember, kick out that third vowel slide. Ready. One and two and ready and play. To make sure that they play that successfully the first time. Okay, so the rhythm, I would have them clap and say the rhythm. What else? Say the note names. What else? Yeah, no, that's great. Go over the roadmap. What's going to happen at the very end? What else?
Can you go over the E and G jump?
I think that is important because what's going to happen, Paige, is that they're going to probably not be firm enough here and they're going to play the C again. So, yeah, you can make sure that they know that the G is firmer. What else?
Talking about the C to D, trying to kick out.
Yes. So going from C to D, gentlemen, is, you know, C, 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 D, and you're kicking out at the same time. So let's do that real quick, just air playing and fingering along. We'll just do the first two measures. So here is C, 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 D. Good. And it's a quick action, but it's not a jerk. It's not anything that's going to destroy your face, all right? One more time. C, 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 D. Good. Now let's play. One, two, one, and two, and ready, and go. Finish the 9th through the 12th partials, harmonic series for trumpet for all the fingers. Make sure you go over all of that. I might just have a quiz over everything we've learned so much.